worldliness is indeed the cause of the plurality. The idea has been very well brought out in other Upanishads also. In Kathopanishad especially, it is said that this outward gaze is the cause for the delusion of the individual, and its redemption lies naturally in learning to do the inward gaze. When the consciousness in us folds its attention from the external world of objects and rolls out its awareness from the body, mind and intellect, it shall come to a state of self-awareness where the consciousness becomes, as it were, conscious of itself. This is called self-realization, and this is the process by which the pluralistic world of delusions can be folded out of cognition.
This is telling you the meditation technique, right?
Yeah.
It's telling you that jo outward gaze hai, usko inward kiya.
Mm-hmm.
So then your sansar fold ho gaya, but now your consciousness, you're focusing, and then one day it becomes...
But you're no longer Uma, or you're no longer Joe, or you're no longer Manju.
You're just consciousness.
Right.
Yeah.
So you used to meditate, you experience that kind of thing?
Yeah.
Even now I'm doing, nowadays mm-hmm. happening. And it's so amazing that
it's
I don't
great.
Have to effort. I just
yeah.
close
yeah.
my eyes and it goes deeper, yeah. deeper, and then all of a sudden I start feeling, and then but then you have to come back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because you cannot keep doing that.
Yeah.
Bhook
like
lagti
you know, when you
bhook lagti hai.
Because kaam jo aapko de rakha hai karne ke liye, aapko karna hai wo kaam.
Kaam to bada mushkil hai.
Ho jayega, wo bhi ek surrender karke karenge to ho jayega, right?
See, this is what I was telling. There's a duty, yeah. See, there's a duty, and you were telling now everything you enjoy doing, not necessarily.
Yeah.
Some of that is given to you that you have to do.
No, that's true. But what her point is that if it is
enjoy
given to you,
karo.
Exactly. So then you have to, you know, like this is what happened to me. Like when I was in
just
in the mission.
Surrender, then if it's given to you,
yeah.
you're not even the karta anymore.
Like, mujhe ek saal ho gaya, I haven't been able to write.
It will happen.
So,
he gave you many more years, right?
7 years diya na. So, 6 years baki abhi, but still, 1 year is gone.
But how do you know? Maybe
the person
mind is preparing.
Who's taking care of you to get all that work done, that person is taking care.
I know, I'm
care.
Getting repaired, then Nina
it's
is
beyond
getting
us to
cured,
understand, but
you know, so
it's happening.
Like
may, something may be happening, for sure.
It's happening. Nahi to ye class aise falto nahi hone wali thi.
No, a little bit.
Nahi, I cannot get even 5 minutes to think separately. When I say, वो अंदर से आता है कि now you have to write, so वो
ना because naturally because when
but ये अभी आने लगा फिर से जैसे actually this this lady I think I sent you one video by Anand Murti Ma that she's Sindhi.
I know Anand Murti Ma.
And she's the one who sings the one I one song I send you you know.
Yeah I know who she is.
Yeah. So I'm listening her bhajan.
Gori Gori jo
hai. Haan, Gori Gori
gol
chhehraya.
Haan, bada, bahut badiya.
Haan.
Uski sexy voice bhi hai. Bahut hi badiya voice.
She sings very well, yes.
So when I hear her voice now, I'm getting into that.
That's good. Because she has a lot of like...
Anand
Murti Ma. I sent you one video of her.
I have listened to her a lot in India.
She has an ashram in Haryana.
I've been to ashram. It's on the way to Haridwar or Delhi ke na beech mein upadta hai.
See, when I went to India... Sikri Sahab had all her tapes, you know. He was showing me those.
Achha.
So that's when I learned about
I used to
her.
Listen to her wo TV pe aati thi. One of the Sony
wo
pe.
Pura
was,
aata
super, super,
Anand Murti
Ma,
you go in
super,
Google
I used
and
to
see.
Tape it and see it.
But she was younger, much younger.
Yeah,
she's
very,
less than,
she's very
Achha,
young.
Now
she's
I
still
she's
young.
Very like, she says it exactly the way
yeah.
it is.
Yeah.
Isko bura lage, kuch dhakya.
Nee, but uski sound voice is so good. It's amazing. So anyway.
Okay, let's do one more.
Yeah.
So here's the Sanskrit. Chitta kala hi ye tanstu. Chitta
kala hi ye antu.
Dvaya kalashta ye bahihi.
Dvaya kalashta ye bahihi.
Kalpita eva te sarve.
Kalpita eva te
sarve.
Visheshyo nanya hetu kaha.
Visheshyo nanya hetu kaha.
Okay, Manju can read. Both are mere imaginations.
Both are mere imaginations. Those that are recognized within us as long as the thought of them lasts, as well as those that are perceived by the senses, which confirm to two points of time. There is no other special ground for for differentiating one from the other. Here, the objection raised by the non-believer of Vedanta is that there is still a clear distinction between the world of objects of dream and the objects in the waking state. According to this school, distinction is that the inner world of thoughts is governed by only one period of time, while the objects of world of objects outside is confined within two points of time. They argue that a thought can remain in the mind and perceptibly protrude itself upon our cognition only so long as the thought lasts in the mind. But in the case of objects outside, they remain whether one cognizes them or not until another period of time. For example, when you are dreaming, they say that the dream can last only so long as the mind is dreaming. But in the outer world of objects, we can qualify the existence of the one object with reference to the existence of another object in time. We can say Mr. Sundar will remain till the town bus arrives. Here, Sundar's departure is governed by another incident, namely the arrival of the town bus, which is to happen in another period of time. Thus, these objectors of ideas of Vedanta make an hair-splitting distinction between the world of objects of the waking state and of the dream state. According to them, the waking state world is more real because they are depending themselves upon two periods of time. That is, they can be confined in terms of two points of time, whereas in the case of dream, their contention is that it is only in the mind and only for such a time as the thought remains in the mind. This is peculiar argument is being totally rejected by Godfather with a single stroke of his pen, as it were, without any ceremony. Since the argument deserves no serious reply, he says that both the points of time which seem to define the objects of the waking state are nothing but imaginations of the mind. They are as much a mere concept of the mind as the dream world is. He concludes that there is no other special ground raised by this objection. Raised by this objection to justify a differentiation between the objects of the waking state and the objects of the dream state.
So you're just telling the difference right now, that in when we are dreaming, it's all mind mein hai, kuch bahar nahi hai. But bahar, the objects are connected with time and space, jo bolte na hum log, right?
Huh.
So there are always two points of time that it may be there, and then when it gets destroyed, that there is a two period of time. It's a little complicated, so I don't think that we need to worry
too
much.
You know, we don't actually need to go into minute details. You just have to get the idea ki om kya hai, humko kaise wo hum fayda hoye om se, and what are the four stages in, and where do I stand, and
right,
where
right.
do I have
you,
to
you
go?
Are right,
that is
but the
thing.
Reason we
yeah.
we
What is the difference?
Godfather was Shankaracharya's guru's guru.
I know, but why is Shankara?
Shankara ne bhi bhashya likha hoga, ho sakta hai.
Yeah,
but
so,
you know,
so
like
he's talking about.
He's talking about Godfather's. The jo verses hum chant karte hai na,
ah.
wo Godfather ne likhe
hoga. Nahin, verses to same hai.
तो फिर ये गॉडपाद की है
हां बट शंकराचार्य
का रिमेंबर गुरु का खुद का भी तो हो जाता है कि आई ऑलवेज से दैट दिस वाज इन मेनंजीज सो इवन इफ
तो इज ही टेलिंग डिफरेंट शंकरा और इज इट द
कमेंट्री नो नो इट्स द सेम इट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज दैट शंकरा वाज गॉडपाद के लीनिएज में थे ना वो तो व्हेन वो शंकरा का बोलेंगे तो गॉडपाद ही हो गए पर लिखा गॉडपाद में है वो
तो बट कमेंट्री तो वो दे
कमेंट्री नहीं ये कमेंट्री तो जो हमारा
स्वामी जी ने दिया
हाँ ये हाँ. स्वामी और आपकी आपकी वो किसी और स्वामी की होगी
नहीं दैट इज जस्ट ट्रांसलेशन बट द कमेंट्री ओरिजिनल इज शंकराज And
no,
Swami
Shankara's
Nikalanand,
is only the verses.
No, it says Shankara's commentary below that.
Oh, then it's possible that Shankaracharyaji...
See, like Iska, my meaning...
Okay, then I know what you're saying.
You say doubt is raised as to the statement that everything is more mere imagination of mind like the dream. For the image nation of mind, such as desire, etc., same.
No, I've understood what it is. It's very simple. It's that in the dream, your mind is projecting a certain thing. In real life also, that dream is prolonged. You are projecting.
The
mind
ka
projection
hai,
don't know. Aise projection hai, aise projection.
Ki jab hum log
waking, both is a projection.
Waking state mein hai na, so we have a help of our senses. Dream mein humare sense fold ho gaye. Mind khali project kar raha hai. So wo jyada real isliye lagta hai ki humare wo senses are involved in it.
Yeah.
Whereas in dream, it's not.
Yeah.
Okay, somewhere it talks
about. But both
about
is a projection.
Both is a projection. And the way I'm looking at it is this. You know, the latest technology, I don't know, did you wear that, what is that?
Virtual reality.
Virtual reality. And once you wear it, it's scary.
Yeah.
I was screaming. I know. They take you on a boat and the shark is coming at you. Blah, blah, blah. And the person is going crazy and other people are laughing at them because...
And you keep saying a snake and not a rope.
Lekin wo jab when the senses are involved, it starts looking real.
Yeah.
That's what happens to us.
Hmm.
It is a dream, but it is
but
so
dream
real.
Also
but
looks
in
real.
Dream, it is real.
That is true.
But this is more intense.
More. That's what I'm trying to get at.
It's more intense
because in the dream, it's still the mind is tired and you know it fades away very quickly.
Yeah.
You know, when we wake up, the dream fades away. But reality is stays with you.
What is basically saying?
It's a longer
projection of the mind.
It's a 70-year dream, 80-year dream.
Yeah. Exactly.
Still
so,
a dream.
See, the thing is, on one hand, we start getting tired and say, why do we have to study? But I think that if we have embarked on the journey, we should finish it. And there are many things come out.
Yeah.
Along, it's still a satsang. You know, we are shutting that, but we discuss so many other things also.
No, but like Zindagi,
but this gives us the
that
focus.
Song, you know, remember?
Mm-hmm.
Zindagi khwab hai. That's what he's saying. Zindagi, life is a dream.
Life is a dream.
Yeah.
Actually, there was a
lot of that the children say, life is but a dream. Gently, gently row your boat.
Row your boat.
No, but this one he talks about, ki Zindagi khwab hai, khwab mein sach kya, jhoot kya.
Yeah.
Sab jhoot hai.
नहीं
सब सच है सब सच
नहीं पर सब सच है झूठ तो जब
डिपेंड्स ऑन एंगल
टाइम आता है तब पता जब खराब हो रहा हो और हम लोग बोले सब झूठ है और भासे नहीं हमको तब सब झूठ है नहीं तो
कोई भी एंगल ले सकता है या कोई एक ने बोला कि ऐसा तो बोलो कि मैं किसी का भी नहीं हूँ दुनिया में या मैं सबका हूँ
या
नहीं तो वो
दोनों वे से यू कैन डू इट
व्हेन आई वाज हियरिंग कृष्णा प्रोग्राम उसमें कृष्ण इज टेलिंग अर्जुन ऑल दिस अबाउट ये रिश्तेदार कुछ नहीं है इनको मार दो ये करो तो धृतराष्ट्र उसको संजय को बोलता है ऐसे तो कोई रिलेशनशिप ही नहीं रहेगी दुनिया में ये तो भड़का रहा है उसे अर्जुन
वो तो ज्ञानी था बेचारा वो उसको यही
वो बेचारा भोला वाले अर्जुन को भड़का रहा है
Yeah. But you know, like I, you know, जो पहली वाली जो महाभारत था ना पहला वाला बहुत पहले साल आया था So somebody had put on my Facebook the section where Krishna Bhagwan talks about this whole Gita.
Huh? Yeah, 45
and
minutes.
And then mine is only like 10 minutes. And I'll forward to all you guys because
unhone
apne shabdon mein bola, but it makes so much logical sense.
Right.
Because it does look like such a horrible act to do.
Yeah.
You know, to kill your own grandfather. Yeah. But then he explained the logic. That, you know, hey, your job is to protect the country.
Yeah.
And then usne
you have to see in a wider vision than just your
Plus you are not killing
that you love.
You are not killing him. You are just killing his body.
Yeah.
No, not from that one. Usne kuch alag dhang se bataya. Usne bola ki, achha, jo dharm ki raksha karna tera kaam hai, right? Aur teri biwi ko leke aur uski wo saadi utarne ki koshish ki. To jab wo maharani thi, उसका ये हाल कर दिया औरत का तो बाकी औरतों का क्या होगा इस दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू फाइट इट्स नॉट बिकॉज़ ऑफ ड्रॉप नो बिकॉज़ यू हैव टू फाइट फॉर ऑल द
राइटियसनेस
एंड देन व्हेन यू आर फाइटिंग ऑल द फॉर दैट काइंड ऑफ हायर सेल्फ इफ समबडी कम्स ऑन द वे And yeah, that you is your relative. That's why you have to kill him. Not because he's bad or nothing of doing. Your goal is this, to protect the country, and this is going to affect the entire country, and then somebody's coming on the way. So
and
I thought that was really good.
Dronacharya was a bit vevash the, because they had to be with, you know,
no,
the
they
ruling,
were vevash because they got because, messed up about his dharma in their head.
Yeah.
They got messed up
so
about
that. So that's what I'm saying, that it because they owed to the ruling family.
Yeah, it's like if a ruling family is doing something horrible. You got to stand
and you
up.
Because you it's your thing over there, you know, your loyalties. So it's wrong loyalties at that time.
It depends on like what definition
which
you
side
get.
You are standing at. I think it depends on which side of the they say
no
which side
but,
of the boat.
But Krishna was as tricky as them. I mean, he was
Krishna
manipulating them.
Yukti se pura kaam kiya.
Like Ashwatthama mara gaya, all that thing, everything he did to...
And he did...
Jo naya wala Mahabharata hai na, usme bahut achha dikhaya hai. Usne dikhaya hai ki wo jo mama tha, Shakuni, wo sab khub manipulate karta tha na. Phir Krishna mane usko challenge kiya. Achha, to main ab terko dikhata hoon ki manipulation kya hota hai.
Right.
Kind of, you know, it was like, I will give you your own medicine, Ghatos. So that's what happened.
Have you heard of this Ghatosham? Ghatosham, with Rajasthan, mein they worship. So that story is about ye jo Bhim tha na. Bhim was married to Hidimba.
Hidimba, right.
And he had a son, Ghatotkach.
Yes.
Rakshas
tha, jo
Rakshasni.
Yeah. And
no, Adha, he was a man, boy.
He was married to the Rakshasni ka jo son tha. Rakshasni ka son tha.
Rakshasni thi, Hidimba aur uska son Ghatotkach.
So Ghatotkach ka jo beta tha, Ghatotkach was married to this Narkasur's daughter.
Okay,
Narkasur was the one which Krishna came to defeat.
Okay.
And they are like 16,000 Rania he had arrested. So he freed them all and then they said, what will happen to us? So he married all of them. That's why they say Krishna has 16,000. So anyway, he had a son. So this daughter of Narkasur, who almost defeated Krishna, I mean, she was very good. She said, what am I going to do now? So he introduces her to this Ghatotkach son.
Okay.
And because she had this test, you know, he has to pass this and all, and he passes. Finally, they have a son.
Ghatotkach and that Narkasur's daughter.
Daughters have a son. So he tells her, goes to Krishna and he says, I want you to train him. So Krishna trains him, the son of...
Of Ghatotkach.
Yeah. It's called Ghatosham, it's called.
Okay.
That's worshipped in Rajasthan, actually.
Interesting.
So he acquired... equivalent to nuclear weapons. In other words, he got this that if he can throw one barn, it will mark everything, and the second barn would kill everything.
Oh, okay.
So Krishna
to test it.
So Krishna takes a leaf of tree and puts it under his foot, and he says, "Okay, kill all that tree, karo." So he does all that, and then the barn hits his foot because the one leaf was under it. So he knew that he has that power. But with that power, they said, it was like a nuclear weapon. He said, you can only side with the side which is weaker. You cannot side with the side which is stronger. So this episode I have of Mahabharata in which Krishna is going left and right, worried. And he said, what's happening? He says, this guy, he's coming in the war.
Oh.
And if he comes, the moment Kaurav becomes... weaker, he's going to go on their side and kill Pandas. And he's going to destroy the whole world.
Okay.
Because gradually he'll keep switching, you know, that is the way he works. So he said, how do I get rid of him? And so he goes to him and he says to him, so he says, oh, he's my guru. So Krishna is his guru. So he says, you never gave me Guru Dakshina.
Oh.
So he says, okay, whatever you want, I'll give you. He says, I want your head.
I remember that.
So he says, but I want to watch Mahabharata. So he said, okay, you will still be able to watch.
Yes.
So he cuts his head puts it on a pole and he watches
he
the whole
Mahabharata.
He watches
everything, yes.
Yeah,
I saw that. I didn't know that ki kaun tha wo.
Yeah, but he is called Ghatosham. He is worshipped in Rajasthan quite.
Because then I heard that after he saw the war, he realized what Brahman is. Like, he literally got self-realized while watching the war. He realized that it's all play of this Shaktis, but actually it's Krishna is the one.
So actually this Mahabharata that they finished, there's a follow-on to Mahabharata also. These are part of those episodes.
Yeah,
because
there are 100,000 episodes, verses.
The jo uska follow-up hai na ki aise kyun hua. Ashwini saw all that. And I thought ki kya zarurat hai.
No. That is, some of that is
But that is basically like it's a thinking thing. Thinking tank.
Yeah, but I thought what's the use of thinking?
No. That's... no, but see, like one more episode is...
Some people like
No, because Arjun, everywhere he used to go, he used to get married.
Time is short, time is not long.
No. But Arjun used to get married, okay, everywhere. So he goes to this Chitrangada. Have you heard of that one?
Yeah.
He goes to the Siam days, he marries Chitrangada.
Those are political moves, obviously.
Yeah, it was. And then he leaves her. He never comes back. Or he was going to Nagkanya or something, she found out and she left him. Then she had a son. And she trained him. He said, my aim in life is to kill Arjun. So when they were doing this Ashwamedh Yag, so they reached that place and first Bhim goes, everybody goes, this guy defeats all of them. Then Arjun goes and he kills his head, separates his head. And
separates whose head?
Uska beta, Chitrangada ka beta. He kills him, Arjun.
Achha.
The head gets separated.
Uh-huh.
Then Krishna comes running. And he finds the head, somebody was running away with it, puts it back the head.
And revives him.
Yeah, revived him,
See, this is what happened that I have heard. Vedvyas, when he wrote Mahabharata, he made a declaration. Anything happens in this world, I have put the situation in Mahabharata. Means political, social, name it, every kind of situation. If it is not in Mahabharata, it doesn't happen in this samsara. Itna boldly unhone bola. That's why there are so many stories.
Aur fir ye bhi hai ki Mahabharat koi family apne ghar mein Mahabharat nahi rakhte, khali Gita rakhte hain ki hamari improvement ho. Mahabharat nahi ki we don't want Mahabharat.
I know, but that is more like a bolte na ki wo vehm wali cheez hai, aisa kuch nahi hai ki Mahabharat, because bahut bahut zyada gyan hai Mahabharat mein. In fact, the Vishnu Sahasra Naam is in Mahabharat too. There's so many things in Mahabharat that you can learn.
But I thought this Abha, Agarwal, she brought a sari from Calcutta, her whole Mahabharat.
On the sari.
That is so interesting.
But in our Chinmaya Mission, they say that it is just a vehem. They just make it up.
The right page.
It's totally fine. You can learn and you can be better people. We can be better people.
There's a new one coming now.
What is it? Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhina Sarve Santu Niramaya Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu
Om Shanti 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 Om Asatoma Satgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shanti
Yajamahi Sugandhyam Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamilam Vandhanam Mrityor Mukshiyam Amritam.
Purnamidam
Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
I know, but she brought her badam, no?
Badam.
Oh, I see.
Plus we'll eat dinner. Eventually we have to eat dinner.
Yeah, imagine.
Om Brahmarpanam Brahmahavi Brahmagno Brahmanahutam Brahmaivatena Gantavyam Brahma karma samadhina.
Okay.